Psalms 35, a psalm of David about David, psalm about the Lord Jesus Christ, and a psalm about Israel. David was hated because he did right. Jesus Christ was hated because he did right. Israel's hated because they're God's people. Plead my cause, O Lord. Plead is to make an attempt. Make an action, usual verbal action. I need someone to stand in. With them that strive with me, fight against me, argue against me, have problems against me. Fight against them with a fight against, fight against them that fight against me. And what David's saying, Lord, give them what they reap. And for the nation of Israel, God said, I will curse them that curse you. And more so with the Lord Jesus Christ. I mean, the Old Testament didn't have Jesus, but they had the Word. And the Israelites were bound to the Word of God, and they were above all nations, because nations didn't have the law, the testimony, and all that. And then when Jesus Christ came around, woe be the people that were around when Jesus was here. Because there's God right there. You didn't listen to him, you're in big trouble. You didn't listen to him when the bodies of the Old Testament saints risen. The Bible said they went to those that believe and didn't go to those that believe not. And when we're in the church age today, when we have the complete 66 books, and in 2020 we can go to the library, we can go online, we can go to the bookstore, we can order on a King James Bible online. We have access to the Word of God. Genesis to Revelation, even woe war to us. Because we have the completed Word. We have what Jesus Christ didn't have. We have what Paul didn't have. And we have what David didn't have. The complete Bible. Woe be to the people of this generation of called the church age, because it's access to them. Unless today you're in a primate area in the deepest part of a jungle somewhere, or you're in a nation that has no electricity, no outside influence of the world, you're without excuse. And there are many nations that say, we don't want that Bible here. You don't mess with the Jew. Take hold of the shield and buckler. Military armor, and stand up for my help. That's David saying, Lord, put the battle on. Let's go to war. David doesn't know about the sword of the Spirit, the shield of faith, and the helmet of salvation. How can you say that they saw Jesus? You know what David's talking about with the shield and buckler? David's a military man. He fought battles. He fought giants. He fought the Philistines. He fought against Saul. For David, the armor of David was physical. The Bible says our armor is spiritual. We don't go out with a sword and start whacking off heads like religions. We go out there and preach the gospel. That's our sword. And today they're turning it to a piece of iron, a piece of steel, bang, 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 bang. That's not our warfare. You're taking yourself back in the Old Testament where David would take a sword, slap off their head. Draw also the spear, armor, military, and stop the way against them that persecute me. And David's saying, listen, I'm in straits, God. I need help. Whip them. You assume that David would not believe what the Jehovah Witnesses would believe, that thou shalt not kill. David's killing, Lord. There's a difference between murder and military action and judgment upon sin. Say unto my soul, David's soul, I am thy salvation. David says, I need reinsurance, Lord. I'm up against it. It don't look good. Now, Lord, I know you're my God. I know you love me, but it don't look good. And many times Christians face that difficulty in their life. Yeah, the Lord loves me. Yeah, the Lord never leave me, forsake me. Lord, where'd you go? Lord, I need help. I've had this prayer. Psalms brings life to a Christian. One moment we're praising God, and next minute, oh, woe is me. Excuse me. Let them, the enemy, be confounded and put to shame that seek after my soul. They want me dead. They want me gone. That's the same thing with Jesus. Judas was put to a shame. He went in there, threw the coins on the ground, and he went and hung himself. And he'll stand before the great white throne judgment as a failure at the law. And all those that were against Jesus, and all those that curse Israel, I'll curse them that curse you. Let them turn back and be brought to confusion that devised my heart. Let them, what am I doing? What's going on? How am I? I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know who I am. And that's one of the, I'm not picking on the disease, but that's one of the things today with our elderly people, dementia, and this loss of memory. And Christians get it too, yes. But many a wicked man, I would think, if it is of God and may not be of God, one of the things is, you know what, I'm just going to make you just lose your mind. You think that would happen? I think, yes, it would happen. There's a point where you, when you read in Pilgrim's Progress, the man that's in the cage, he got so far, you know what? There was absolutely no help for him at all. And he was locked up. And to be locked up that you don't know who you are, you don't know who your family is, and you're just an enemy of God. You're in a cage around yourself. And that can happen to Christians too. Especially those, the Bible says, that don't take part in the Lord's Supper correctly. Illnesses or even death. You don't want to mess with the Lord. You don't want to get God angry. If you get him to the point where, I mean, there's just no relief from his anger against you, you're in trouble. Again, I will curse them that curse you and those that mess with Jesus. They say, and I read, I don't know the full story, but they say Pilate became a madman. I don't know. But Pilate had more of a chance than I had more of a chance. Thomas said, my Lord, my God, I believe in. Jesus said, you know, blessed are you for that believe in, but blessed are those that have never seen me, Thomas. There's a whole bunch of people are going to believe, Thomas, and they've never seen me. Pilate stood in the face of God and said, what is true? And that was the last word that Jesus ever said to Pilate. It's, you know why, the Bible says, you know why we're going to judge angels? It's simple. An angel has seen God and Jesus Christ and the devil and the cherubim. And an angel cannot get saved by a man's salvation. And we will judge angels because we have put our faith in God who we've not seen, where there are fallen angels who did not put their faith in God who they've seen. That's a big difference. God's going to say, hey, come here, you. You're flesh and blood, yes. And you believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. And he said, yes, I did, sir. You want to tell that to this angel that was here in glory for all since I created him? I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and was saved. I tell those angels, depart from me, workers of iniquity. It's far worse for an angel to reject God and seen God than a man who has not seen God and reject him. I mean, that's like walking up, seeing the sun, and saying, oh, the sun's not yellow. It's right there. Yo, I don't believe. Okay. Let them be as chaff before the wind, and that's the harvest time. That's the wheat. They would ground the wheat, grind it up, And then they would take pitching forks and they'd throw it up in the air and let the breeze take the chaff, the non-seed, the refuse, the waste. It would blow that away. And what fall would be the seed. And they'd keep doing it and keep doing it and keep doing it. There was nothing left of the seed. Let that chaff go away. Let it blow away. Who cares where it goes? You don't keep track of the chaff. Chaff has become dust and dirt. That's what David's saying about the enemies of David. That's what's going to happen to the enemies of Jesus. That's what's going to be happening to the enemies of Israel. We're going to trample on them. Once the fire comes out of Jesus' mouth, we're going to walk on them. Chaff. Let the angel of the Lord. Now we saw him in chapter 34, verse 7 as omnipresent, let the angel of the Lord chase them. Here he is again. He's omnipresent and he's omnipotent, powerful. He's everywhere and he's all power. You know, we're going to be riding behind Jesus at the second advent. We don't need to be there. We're just going along with the ride. I mean, we're going to be in armor, Joel says. We're not going to need our armor. Jesus Christ is going to take care of it all. Yeah, I could be mistaken, but I don't know if they ever rose a battle in Jericho. All they did is blow the trumpets and the wall came down. They went in there and got Rahab and burnt the city. Let their way, the enemy's way, be dark and slippery. Not go anywhere. If you do go anywhere, you're not going to make no footing. Let the angel of the Lord persecute them. Wow, the angel of the Lord is very busy. And the angel of the Lord in the Old Testament is Jesus Christ. By the way, he's the angel of the Lord in the gospel. Excuse my throat. Wherever you see the angel of the Lord, that's Jesus Christ. He's busy. He's powerful. And that angel of the Lord that said, hey, I'm everywhere. Hey, angel of the Lord, go chase them. Hey, angel of the Lord, persecute them. Hey, Jesus, who hit you? Get over here, Jesus. Let me whip you. Hey, man, Jesus, let me put this crown of thorns on your head. Give me the whip. Come on. Who do you think you are, Jesus? Think you're God? Ha, ha, ha. All the need of this man. You wait till Jesus takes hold of them at the judgment seat of Christ. You imagine Jesus at the judgment saying, come here. You're the third one that hit me right here in the cheek. You hit me right in the nose. I bow the knee to me, you know, in purple, bow the knee to majesty, Roman soldier. I don't know if Pilate got saved, but Pilate, come here. What is true? It's right here. If he didn't get saved, depart from me, worker iniquity. Nero, you've set Christians on fire. Well, wait to see what I'm going to do with you. Go jump in the lake. Now that's power. Imagine God, the angel of the Lord, persecuting them. You imagine God just persecuting. Where are you going to go and get away from God? Where are you going to hide from God persecuting you? For without cause have they hid from me their net in a pit, set in traps. They're trying to trap. And they did that with Jesus all the time. Excuse me, Jesus. Yes, Sadducees, we don't believe in the resurrection, but in the resurrection, whose wife shall she be? Well, first of all, there is a resurrection. You don't believe in the resurrection, and you do err the scriptures. Well, Jesus, yeah, come on, come at me again. Shall we pay taxes or shall we not pay taxes? You know, we caught this woman in the very act of adultery. The law says, where's the man? They set traps and traps. Judas set the ultimate trap. He knew exactly where Jesus would be with just the 11 and no one else. Which without cause they had digged for my soul. You know, every time Jesus healed on the Sabbath, they got together and said, we're going to kill him. We're going to destroy him. And they had no happiness in their heart. Let destruction come upon him at unaware. Be not deceived. God's not mocked. Whatsoever man soweth, that he shall also reap. Let his net that he has hid catch himself. Judas died. I know Christ died, but Judas killed himself. In that very destruction, let him fall. Imagine a moment when the priest went into the temple that day and they saw that the veil was rent. I cover this up real quick. No one can find out about this. A priest? Yeah, you realize we just talked to David out in the courtyard? How'd you talk to David? David's out there. Samuel's out there. Where? He was just here talking to some And we're here. We saw them. What did they say to you? Nothing. We didn't talk to you? No, they didn't talk to us. But we saw them. And my soul shall be joyful in the Lord, as it should be, and shall rejoice in his salvation. Should be. His salvation, not ours. So when somebody gets saved because you witness to them, it's not you saving them, it's the Lord saving them. All my bones shall say, Lord, who is like unto thee, which delivereth the poor from him that is too strong for him? Yea, the poor and the needy from him that spoileth. Evidently, I get your bones cry out. Maybe that day when we get our brand new body. Oh, no more aches, no more pains. No more muscle rub, no more pain relief. Oh, Lord God, it hurts. Oh, man. This body's old. Ow, Lord. Sore. Pain. Verse 11 to 17, definitely, Jesus, false witnesses, knows the plural, did rise up. Man, they came out of the woodwork to testify against Jesus. There were so many, they couldn't even agree with each other. They laid to my charge things I knew not. Now, David didn't know, but Jesus knew. You can't take a type 100%. Now, Joseph is the greatest type of Christ. But Jesus never hit a cup to catch his brothers at a lie. That didn't happen. They rewarded me evil for good to the spoiling of my soul. Of all the good that Jesus did, what did they do? They tried to stone him. They tried to trick him. And then they gave him a cross. For what? Pilate said four times, I find no fault in him. Crucify him. What did he do? He made himself equal with God. Even the Jews and the officers of the religion of Jesus' time understand who Jesus said he was, unlike the Jehovah's Witnesses. But as for me, when they were sick, my clothing was sackcloth. I humbled my soul with fasting. And prayer returned unto my own bosom. That's Jesus and David. Jesus went around healing his enemies as far as he could. When they would not listen to him and not believe him, the Bible said he couldn't do anything. And he marveled at their unbelief. David did it too. David had Saul in his grips twice, and Saul spared his life. I mean, David spared Saul's life. I behaved myself as though he had been my friend or brother. Bible says Jesus came on his own received him not. I bow down heavily as one that mourneth for his mother. Jesus wept. Jesus groaned in the spirit. But in my adversary, they rejoice. That's not reaping and sowing. That's not natural. And gather themselves together. Yea, the adjuncts, that's the lowest class of people, gather themselves together against me. And I knew it not, of course Jesus did. Jesus knew what they thought. They did tear me and seize not. David, David didn't have any idea who was against me, who was against him or not. I think one time he says, listen, are you for me or are you for my foes? But David went around helping people. David went one time with his troops and took care of Nabal's sheep and Nabal's men. And what did he get in response? He didn't get nothing. He didn't even get a cheeseburger. Except when Abigail came. David treated Saul with kindness and respect, and what did he get? He got spears thrown at him to the wall. He got put out in the wilderness on the run. Jesus said, the birds have nests, but I don't even have a place to lay my head. I'm going around healing people. I'm going around helping people. I'm going around teaching about God. And there's one point they said, they all went home, something like that, and in the next chapter it said, verse 1, he went to the mountain. And the Bible tells us many times when he did that, he went off and prayed all night. Here he is praying. Bible says in the garden, he prayed great drops of blood. Man, it wasn't just, oh, Lord God, I don't want to, Lord, please. Let's. Man, Jesus was grieved. Jesus was broken. Jesus had great feelings in that garden that day. And you imagine he turns around. All right. You guys are asleep? Really? You couldn't watch 1 hour? And he goes back and goes back for another hour. And then comes back, finds him asleep. With hypocritical mockers. I like hypocritical mockers. I meet them in a public ministry almost every week. In feasts. Passover, Pentecost, Tabernacles. They were there when Jesus was there, and all they were was hypocrites. You hypocrites, Pharisees, scribes, and vipers, and serpents, and called them every name under the sun. And people, you ought not to say that. That's not what Jesus would do. If Jesus came and talked to your pastor the way he talked to them in the Gospels, your pastor would faint down, have a heart attack, and need the medics with the paddles and life support. They gnash upon him with their teeth. That's Stephen. Now, I don't know when they chewed Jesus, but they did that to Stephen. Unless you're a Catholic, you gnash upon Jesus. You think you are. Lord, how long will doubt look on? Rescue my soul from their destruction. My darling from the lions. Oh, I wonder who that lions are. The devils. The devil's plural. He's in that garden. Lord, this cup could pass from me. Nevertheless, thy will be done. I will give thanks in the great congregation. David says, in a group of people, I'm going to give thanks to God. I will praise thee, God, among much people. So we're to tell people about what God does for us all the time. But the world don't want to hear it. Go walk in a grocery store and just start yelling out how much Jesus loves you. And see how quick you're escorted out the door. Let not them that are my enemies wrongfully rejoice over me. Lord, protect me from doing wrong so I don't make the enemy rejoice. Because if they rejoice, then I'm doing something wrong against you and I've given you a bad name. Neither let them wink with their eye that hate me without a cause. You know, that wink. Got to watch out for winkers. For they speak not peace. And if it's not peace, it's war and turmoil. But they devise deceitful matters against them that are quiet in the land. That's Israel land. You know, Jesus Christ brought about peace in his time. Guys in mystery, woman's bowed over in great pain. Jesus healed them and took care of them. It's the Pharisees, the scribes, and the Sadducees that had the turmoil. The disciples are going through the fields one day, just, you know, getting some wheat. What are you guys doing? Doing it on the Sabbath. Who do you think you are? Gotta have a meeting. Gotta kill them all. There was peace in the book of Acts. Unto the Pharisees, scribes, and the Sadducees and Sanhedrin got all upset because they're preaching Jesus. You know who gets upset when the preaching of Jesus? Those who don't believe on Jesus, who think they believe Jesus, and think you're doing it wrong. And they're doing it right. And what are they doing? They're not doing anything at all. I let my light shine. Show me in the Bible where Jesus let his light shine. He didn't have a halo walking around. You imagine if Jesus had that halo, like, who are you? Oh, I'm sorry. That halo should have gave you away. You know? It's ridiculous. Jesus let his light shine. Man, he was like any ordinary Jew. That woman at the well says, you know, hey, you know, you Jews don't have anything to do with us. And she said, you know, we've heard about the Messiah would come. Jesus says, I'm him. Now, if he glowed in the dark, she would know, hey, you're God. Look at you. You're glowing. Yea, they opened their mouth wide against me, Jesus. Those Pharisees had union meetings and union meetings after the disciples and Jesus. And they said, aha, aha, our eyes have seen it. And they rejected it. They said one point when Peter and John or James, I forget, they're in the temple. Here's a guy, he's maimed, he can't walk, and he's walking around. And the Bible says he's leaping. He's running around just praising God. And they're like, we've seen it. We know this miracle has happened. Why are you so upset? You don't have anybody in your family that has disease that they could bring to the disciples and say, hey, listen, we want to believe in this Jesus too. We want them to be healed. You know, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the scribes never brought anybody. You know, I don't think anybody of them, their family ever got saved. Saved by healing. But when the centurions, the Romans came, sir, I got a member of my staff, and he's home sick with palsy. I really believe you, Jesus. Okay, fine, go home. He's well. Okay, and he's on his way home in service. Hey, the guy got saved like 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Hey, that's the same time Jesus said. Though this thou hast seen, O Lord, God's seen it, keep not silent. Speak up, Lord. O Lord, be not far from me. That's a proper prayer in this day and age. Stir up thyself, awake to my judgment. Ooh, here's Second Advent. Even to my cause. What will be David's cause, nation of Israel? He's the king. My God, my Lord, Jesus Christ, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Judge me. Oh, you see somebody walk. You see David Penny now. David, what you writing? I'll write down Psalm 35, verse 24. And what are you saying? Judge me. It's not easy to be judged, David. Bad boy. Don't you know what the scriptures are going to say one day? It's going to say, Jesus said, judge not, lest ye be judged. We've seen it. Judge me. You know what David's saying? Same thing I say. And this is something I preach and do. Lord God, what in my life is bothering you? Lord, you know I got this sin in my life and I do it and I'm sorry. I get victory sometimes and I don't get the victory other time. Lord, help me. That's what David's saying. I can think one of the things with David and Solomon, with all the... I think David had a problem with women. I think one of the things, David, you know, let's work on your conscience a little bit. Okay, Lord, judge me. Yeah, I know I got a lot of wives. I got trouble with women. I don't know. I'm just saying. Judge me, Lord. I'm a sinner. That is for the people. Judge not. They should be. They don't want God. They don't want God to be revealed in their life for what they're doing because they enjoy it. I love to be a cannibal in the name of Jesus, which the Bible says not to do it. Before the law, during the law, Gospels, and New Testament. It is perfectly proper to say, God, close the door, you and me, just you and me. I don't care about the guy who sits over the pew. I don't care about the pastor. I don't care about my wife right now. I don't care about my boss. With you and me, Lord, judge me where I'm at wrong. And there may be sins in my life, Lord, I do not know about, and I do know about the sins I'm doing. Come on, Lord. We got to get it right now. Oh, Lord, my God. Oh, Lord, my God. That's a part of a hymn. You know what the world today says? OMG. I rebuke somebody. They're typing the OMG. It's not that off. OMG. According to thy righteousness. God, you know what? Judge me. Why? Because I want to be right. Who's right, God? You're right. Judge me by your righteousness so I can be right. And let them not rejoice over me. Let them not say, hi, look at that sinner. Look at him sin. He's no better than us. And when the devil comes up and accuses the brethren, and look at, and for the Christian today, I don't know what it'd been for, except for the time of Job, where the Lord goes, but when the devil goes up today, it's like, hey, look at that sinner. Look at that Christian sin. And Jesus would turn to the Father and say, today, yeah, Father, he sinned. It's under the blood. And we have a battle with him with that. We're trying to help him. The Holy Spirit is going overtime to work on that heart of his. He's trying. He loves us. Let them not rejoice over me. Let them not say in their hearts, the enemy, ah, so would we have it. Let them not say, we have swallowed him up. We've got the victory. We're the winners. That's what they did with Dagon. When they captured Saul, when they captured Samson. Look at our God, Samson. They had a celebration to Dagon Day. Dagon it. And they made Samson grind in the grindhouse. And they made him expose himself nakedly with that little boy saying, look at the little Philistine boy with that big, hunky Jewish person. Look at it. You see what Dagon did? You know what they took the credit off? They took the credit off David that afternoon with Goliath. You see how they did that? Wasn't there a big Philistine giant and a little shepherd boy of Israel? Did he not get the victory? Well, that afternoon, Samson had, look at that big Jewish guy. Look at that little boy. That little Philistine boy. He goes to Dagon every week. I mean, they were singing, I don't know what they were singing, but they were singing the fellows saying, Dagon's got the victory, Dagon's got the victory. He's victor over Jehovah. David said, don't let that happen to me. Don't let me fail you, God. Let them be ashamed, the enemy, and be brought to confusion again together that rejoice at my hurt. Let them be clothed with shame and dishonor that magnify themselves against me. Now look at David and look at as Jesus. Do you realize when Jesus died on that cross to the Pharisees, Sadducees, that was victory. He's dead. Finally got rid of him. Yes. All right. Gone. Won't have to hear that man no more. And what is it, Acts 3 or 4? What's going on out there? They're preaching this resurrection Jesus again. This guy's, you know, that guy's begging at the temple? Yeah, he's up and around. He's jumping around praising God. Get those guys in here right now. You guys shut up. I don't want you to preach in that name of Jesus anymore. We got rid of him. Saying he resurrected. You know why they got mad at the resurrection? Because if he got mad at the resurrection, Jesus is alive. Their enemy arose. They didn't want to hear that. Jesus is the victor. Popes die and stay in the grave. Religion dies and stay in the grave. But Christ arose from the grave. The angel said, he's not here. Where is he? He's risen. I had a family member he's not there at the place where he was buried. They moved him to another tomb. He didn't move Jesus. He went to heaven. Shame and dishonor. Imagine all the religious people in Jesus' time standing before Jesus, the one they said and gave a hard time and crucified. Let them shout for joy and be glad and favor my righteous cause. Let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified. That's us in New Jerusalem. Can you imagine giving God the praise and your voice is not going to get tired? Your voice won't get scratchy. You won't get sleepy. You'll be forever alive and well and just praising God with a holy, righteous tongue. Nonstop. You won't need to get a drink of water. Which has pleasure and prosperity of his, look at, of his servants. God wants to give us prosperity. For the Jew, it's the land. You know what it is for the Christian? Crowns, rewards, and inheritance. You don't get that right now. Now, God does bless us, God does give us mercy, and God does give us gifts. But see, the prosperity gospel, you know, God will give us everything we want. And my tongue shall speak of thy righteousness in glory, and all thy praise all the day long. That's got to be the millennium, and that's got to be in the eternal life.